Hey guys, welcome back. So today we're checking out a whole bunch of game trailers that just got released from E3 and Ubisoft Forward. This one really kind of took me by surprise. We didn't know this was coming at all. Well, I didn't. We're getting a Marvel's Guardian of the Galaxy game. Now, we just had the Avengers game come out a few months back, and to be honest, I didn't want to go anywhere near it because it just doesn't look very good. But I'm curious about this one because big fan of James Gunn and the Guardians. What he did was sensational. So if we're going to get a game set in that world, I'm intrigued. So we're going to check out three videos today. I got they did the reveal trailer, a gameplay trailer, and a deep dive. So I'm going to do them all back to back. So this first one is the official reveal trailer. I'm excited. Let's take a look. 3, 2, 1, go. So it's just development footage at the moment from Square Enix. Okay. Please be good.
I am so proud of you.
Wow, nowhere?
Do you know what a birthright is, Peter? Something that's a part of you. Like your name.
Guardians of the Galaxy?
What? No, Rocket. So I let Groot fill out the paperwork.
Guardians of the Galaxy. So obviously they don't have the...
We appear to be 6,963 units short.
I know.
They don't have the likeness of Chris Pratt.
If you see anything with claws the size of Drax, let me know.
We got this.
Drax, roll.
No!
It looks good.
You want monster? I'll show you monster!
No! We disrobe!
Keep your pants on.
Although, it could be used as a distraction.
Looks good. I like the character designs. I know they gotta mix it up.
We're all professionals here, right? Maybe we can work something out.
Get him!
You had one job, Quill.
I did exactly what...
You are Star-Lord.
That's who? It's literally in your contract.
I made no such commitments.
In less than 3 cycles, all would be lost. The galaxy cannot be saved, Peter Quill.
We can do this together.
Fucking great, Quill!
Sun-Lord, right?
It's
Star-Lord. Hey, man. Looks cool.
No, no, of course I will. I'll call you.
Dude, what? No. That was a cool trailer. Like I said, the, just the reveal. And yeah, it looks interesting. I got a better vibe from this one than from the Avengers game that we got out. It just looks better. Now, the only thing is with that trailer, they really must have hated it. When they saw the He-Man Revelation, well, the Masters of the Universe Revelation trailer dropped the other day, because they used the exact same song to much better effect. It was an amazing trailer. They nailed it. So to hear it again in this one, and I know this would have been made, you know, months ago, they must have just gone, oh, fuck. God damn it. Because it's a classic song. Okay, so diving into the next video, this is the gameplay first look. This goes for 11 minutes, so strap in, guys. It's going to be a little bit longer, but I'm really curious about this so far. It looks interesting. 3, 2, 1, go. The character designs, I'm buying it. I mean, he's no Chris Pratt, but he looks cool.
37 units?
We appear to be 6,963 units short.
If we intend to keep our ship, Peter Quill.
I know. We clearly need a plan.
What about selling Gamora's crap?
What?
Oh, come on. You've been hoarding them stupid knickknacks ever since you first joined us. I mean, Don't tell me they ain't worth nothing.
The quarantine zone was always
holding out on us.
My figurines are not knickknacks.
Team's in trouble.
My figurines.
To make no sacrifice.
I will sacrifice.
Oh, okay, so you get dialogue options.
Guys.
Cool.
I think we should hero group for once.
Nice. It looks great.
The problem with your plan is that Lady Hellbender
says Rocket
only buys monsters, and you are not a monster.
Groot, are you really offering to?
No, no, he is not offering that. Okay?
It could work.
So Groot, I guess we could bust him out after.
Absurd. Lady Hellbender seeks the monster within. The small, ugly one is clearly the correct choice. He's cruel, sadistic, and his soul is filthy and filled with rage.
I vote we sell Groot. I honestly think Lady Hellbender will go for it.
Yeah, well, I vote for not.
I also vote for the creepy little beast.
Two votes each. Peter?
Oh my god, this is cool.
Well, Rocket's definitely scarier on the inside. He's unstable and vicious and totally oblivious to the needs of others.
Okay, we get it.
All right, let's do this.
I'm in the room.
Let's go sell a monster.
I like the dialogue options, that's cool. The choices. The
weather patterns of Seknarf 9 are tied to the temperament of his ruler.
That's not how women work.
Or weather.
The voice acting's good too.
Nah, he's not flying at all.
Guys, relax! Just one minor adjustment!
I ever mentioned how much I hate rain?
Hellbender's castle isn't even that far! That is not a castle.
Hellbender's castle.
Fortress.
So how do we impregnate it?
Ask Peter!
Let's just get closer. We'll figure it out on the way.
Looks great.
There is nothing to figure out. As beast merchants, we will easily gain access to Lady Hellbender. Good! We've already got a beast. All that's left is the merchant part.
Good thing I put on my official merchant costume.
There is no such thing.
How do you get over there?
Right?
Fact you ain't sure, don't boat so good.
Whoa! That is some really crazy lightning out there. Never seen anything like it.
Meteorological suicide is what it is.
I like his jacket. Star Lord. This looks incredible. I wonder if you get to play as different characters as well, like you mix it up.
Hey, is my jacket
surely.
All right?
At least you got a jacket. Some of us are soaking here.
Less whining, more walking.
Hey, Stormlord. We ain't seriously walking through this.
Stormlord.
Stop complaining. The hardship will strengthen your spirit.
I face more than enough hardship. Thank you very much.
You are welcome.
Wow.
We got this.
It's like a real-time environment. You literally got to go and traverse this whole thing. Uh-oh. Getting engrossed there.
Everyone okay? We should have gone to Macbook Pro.
The hell?
It would be wary rodent.
You know what? I survived freaking half world. I think I'm scared of some little.
It's not alone. Get ready.
What the?
What are these things? They are amorphous vermin.
Shoot first. Questions later.
Oh, you can. You got controls.
Smash him off, Drax! Meet your maker!
Steel boy's enjoying this way too much!
This is the local fauna!
It's about to be an endangered species!
Groot! Hogtie time!
I am Groot!
Time to go boom!
Oh, I like that. That was cool.
I am eager to experience Lady Hellbender's legendary menagerie. Should we ask them
Gamora
for directions?
Gamora wants to chat.
I'm thinking maybe they are directions.
Like a signpost or
something. I'm not saying it's an arrow with the word fortress on it, but statues suggest civilization, and the only
the dialogue is good.
I saw when we were topside
was Lady Hellbender's fortress.
Dead end. That's just great.
It definitely feels better than the Avengers game.
Too bad the controls are on the other side of the giant chasm.
What do you not have time to dawdle in this jungle? I shall hurl the creature over the chasm so he may activate the bridge.
I may activate a hole through your face! Put me down!
Encourage Drax.
Fine. Just curl up in a ball.
What?
Drax, oh no!
No!
Very well!
Peter!
It's okay, he'll land on his feet.
Ooh. Oh, not on his feet.
I guess that only applies to
Rocket
cats.
Is furious that you let Drax throw him.
I am not familiar with these words. Order the beast to do its job.
So that's going to carry on the emotion. He's going to remember that.
We'll raise your cut by 5%.
Do you control him now?
Okay, deal.
Well, you had to throw him across. How else, unless it, like, there would have been another path to get across if you said, don't throw him.
If you even think of pulling that stunt again.
Hear that?
Guys.
That's funny. Oh, we've got more of these jelly crystal things. Oh, crap. These things are straight out of Stranger Things. Oh crap, things just escalated.
These creatures are perfect predators.
They're perfect predators. The combat looks good, looks fun. What happens if somebody dies? Break free.
Guys, huddle up!
I'm loving the dialogue.
Already missing the jiggle jellies.
They keep moving around.
I'm sure this game is gonna be loaded full of amazing songs.
This guy barely feels it.
Yeah, I smell it.
I don't give a damn about my bad reputation. I won't sing, I promise. I keep doing that though. Oh, go Drax. Down.
That is definitely my top.
That's cool.
Peter?
Aren't you forgetting something?
Are you Groot?
Oh, right. The cage.
The point of even getting the Flarkin thing was looking like we mean business.
Alright, Rocket. Time to put on your monster face.
I only got one face, Quill.
Are you sure about this, Peter?
Look at him! You better have one hell of a sales pitch.
Maybe Gamora's right. We should try selling Groot instead.
What? Really?
This is an affront to democracy.
I just think that we might need Rocket on the outside for this one.
Yeah, we
know.
So noticed.
you can just change it at the drop of a hat.
Then you better not mess this up.
Oh, cool.
You hang tight.
Repercussions.
When the time comes, I'll get you out of there. Rocket style if I gotta.
Sick.
Yeah. Gamora, can you help me with this? What? Why?
To guarantee your safety as a leader.
Oh, come on.
Don't look at me. I ain't pulling that thing. Remember, buddy, menacing like me, only bigger.
I am Groot.
Not bad.
The cinematics look great. I mean, that detail in Rocket's face, so good. All the fur.
Easy, big guy. So, how long before someone else wants to pull this thing?
We are 60 clicks from the fortress.
I'd say closer to 75.
60 clicks? Wow, it looks really, really good.
What are you doing?
And it's some hectic action.
Who's the monster now?
Wow.
Guardians of the galaxy.
Shit, who's this?
How many times do I have to kill you? The audacity that you thought you could rob me. Dweller, feast upon them!
Jesus. Boss battle. You got this. Probably. Wow, man. October 26, 2021. A few months away. Cosmic Deluxe Edition. I'm mostly about downloading digitally these days. I had to say that twice. But, yeah, I'm actually kind of surprised about how much I'm enjoying this. It's looking really, really good. So, this is the last trailer we're looking at. This is the Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, the deep dive. And this just goes for just over 4 minutes. So we're going to get a bit more of a deep dive into it, you'd say. I'm just going to play now. 3, 2, 1, go. Shut up. All right, lay it on me, guys. So far, yeah, very positive response from me.
Hi, my name is Olivier Prou, senior producer here at Eidos Montreal.
Hello.
For the past few years, we've had the privilege to work on our version of Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy and reimagine it into a single-player, story-driven, third-person action-adventure game.
Cool.
It's our own fresh take on the Guardians, and something that's really unique to our game is that you get to be Peter Quill. As Star-Lord, you're constantly in the middle of the action as you try to lead this band of misfits. But today, I'm really, really excited to have all of you join us on this journey, and you'll hear more about the game from our team behind this project.
Right, let's do this. I've always loved Marvel's cosmic characters. Growing up as a kid, I read them, enjoyed them, loved them. I had the opportunity to write for Marvel on some of their cosmic titles. I went back with the help of Bill Roseman, the editor, and kind of cherry-picked characters from Marvel's past.
The opportunity here was to build a team, but to make it all underdogs, so that the reader would think, oh my gosh, how is this team gonna survive?
And that became the Guardians of the Galaxy comic, which we loved working on.
I remember the first time that the Marvel crew came to Montreal. We were showing them the design of the characters, how they would look, and they stayed silent. I don't know if it's a minute, but in my head, it was a minute. I was like, oh my God, like they hate it.
We realized
how now they look great.
Marvel and Eidos Montreal share and have in common, and that we knew the Guardians were in perfect hands.
Looking at the samples that Eidos were kind enough to show me, I think he's fantastic and absolutely in the spirit of what these characters are.
What makes the gameplay experience unique to me is no matter in what phase of the game you are, whether you're in exploration or you're fighting, the Guardians are constantly around you and you never feel alone. While you're the leader, the Guardians will
motion
also
capture,
challenge
nice.
You and make decisions on their own, and you will have to adapt to it.
You are literally part of the Guardians of the Galaxy.
The decisions you'll make will have lighthearted to haunting repercussions, and the game will react to what you do and say.
Gamora, no killing teammates!
Says who?
It's literally in your contract!
I made no such commitment.
You are playing as Star-Lord, and you're using your blasters, and you're using your jet boots.
Star-Lord is really empowering. He's very agile on the battlefield. He can slide and over with his jet boots. Of course, he has his elemental blasters that have different powers as well. And on top of all of this, he can use the unique abilities of his guardians.
We're not pirates. We're legally incorporated heroes for hire.
Guardians of the Galaxy?
What? No!
The story is about a group of misfits, the Guardians. In our world, they've been together for less than a year. They create something on a small scale that looks insignificant. And as they progress through the story, they discover that they created something really big that threatens the galaxy.
There are a lot of very interesting villains in the Marvel franchise. And when you're starting to work on a story like this, you get to get your pick of which ones will make the best for this story. That gives us the opportunity to bring in some that are well known, but some that are also not all that well known.
A bit more obscure. Who's this?
What Eidos
is so right about who's she meant to be?
Is capturing what it's like to be a misfit family. You're also bringing an amazing imagination to it. You're gonna see planets and characters that are gonna blow your mind.
Interpreting it in its own way, I think, makes it feel incredibly fresh and exciting. It's not a matter of trying to replicate the comic or trying to replicate the film. It's trying to take the medium you're working in and make the best version of Guardians out of that.
They made it fun, they made it rock and roll. They delivered everything you would want in a Guardians game.
Yeah, it feels like they've definitely captured the essence of the Guardians and the characters with a big dose of fun. I want to play this. This looks very, very cool. All the things. Nice. Okay, like I said, I was taken aback because the Avengers, we know the Avengers game was just not very well received. So to be in, to bring another Marvel property to like the game front is, it would have been a little bit nerve-wracking for them because we don't want a repeat of that, right? And the Avengers, yeah, they're a beloved property, but so are the Guardians. I mean, because of what James Gunn did with the movies, they really kind of made them something special. I haven't read the books a lot. I haven't really dived into Marvel as a comic reader for a long time. So the Marvels, the movies were my entry point. So obviously you're going to get that comparison between, you know, the movies and then a game property doing something different. Like, obviously they haven't got the rights to, I don't know. They probably don't have the rights to, you know, Chris Pratt's face and everyone else that's part of the movie. But like I said, it really does feel like they captured the essence of the characters. And the story does look like it's going to be fun. And I just love the dialogue. The banter was very cool. So please discuss below what do you think of this game. Are you excited for it? What do you expect? And I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.